Hello everyone, today we're gonna touch a little bit on Intel. Like Boeing, Intel was once a darling of the tech world. It was a pioneer and leader in the semiconductor field. The difference is that Boeing's decline has been very visible with incidents like plane crashes and cabin doors falling off mid-air. Intel, however, quietly slipped out of the spotlight without much notice. Recently, news of Qualcomm's potential acquisition of Intel has brought this well-known American company back to the media spotlight. Many outsiders might be shocked and wonder, what happened to Intel? How did it fall to the point of being acquired? Okay, let's briefly talk about this. First, let's recall Intel's glorious past. Intel was founded in July 1968 by two American engineers, Robert Noyce and Gordon Moore. Yes, that's a Moore who proposed Moore's Law. And Noyce, also a notable figure, was one of the inventors of the silicon integrated circuit. Due to the founder's reputation, Intel was born with a golden key, attracting significant initial investments from the capital markets. For decades, Intel dominated the global chip market. In the 1990s and early 21st century, thanks to its collaboration with software giant Microsoft, often referred to as the Wintel Alliance, Intel monopolized the CPU market for personal computers. But all of that is history. In recent years, Intel's revenue has sharply declined, down 20% in 2022 and 14% in 2023. In Q2 2024, the company reported a net loss of $1.6 billion and announced plans to cut 15,000 jobs to reduce costs. Intel stock price has also dropped nearly 60% from its peak. Once the most valuable company in the chip industry, it now watches Nvidia surge ahead. Many believe Intel's downfall from the top of the chip world only happened in the past 2 to 3 years, mainly because it failed to catch the AI wave. But that's not entirely true. I visited Intel's headquarters in San Francisco in 2020, and Intel had long been laying the groundwork for AI chips. However, seeing the future doesn't guarantee you can keep up with it. As the saying goes, Rome wasn't built in a day. The decline of this once glorious kingdom is a result of many years of strategic missteps. Let's explore the logic behind Intel's current predicament. It all started with Intel missing out on the mobile phone market boom. What initially propelled Intel to the top was its personal computer and server chip business. However, Intel was reluctant to shift its chip production and design resources from PCs and servers to the rising mobile phone sector. Although Intel made some investments and strategic adjustments for the mobile market, they weren't enough to bring about a substantial change. During this time, Intel optimized its chips for computing performance, but neglected power efficiency, a critical factor for mobile devices. Meanwhile, the ARM architecture designed by the UK-based ARM Holdings gained market recognition for its low power consumption, eventually becoming the standard for mobile chip design. Another competitor, Qualcomm, seized the opportunity by developing high-performance chips for phones and took over the mobile chip market. Intel stuck in the middle could only watch the mobile market slip away. It's not that Intel never had opportunities. In the mid-2000s, when Apple was preparing to launch its iPhone, it approached Intel for a partnership to supply chips for the phone. At that time, Intel was already Apple's Mac processor supplier, so there was a foundation for collaboration. However, Intel's leadership believed Apple's offer was too low and rejected it, underestimating the potential of the mobile phone market. Apple then turned to Samsung for its chips, And later, Samsung began designing its own chips and outsourced manufacturing to TSMC. Over time, this company's path diverged. Intel is one of the few companies that integrates both chip design and manufacturing, and for a time it led in both areas. But with decades of globalization and the offshoring of US manufacturing, Intel has fallen far behind its Asian competitors, TSMC and Samsung, in advanced chip production. Intel's management has tried to take advantage of the current trend of reversing globalization and bringing manufacturing back to the US, hoping to catch up at least to Samsung. However, several attempts to acquire foundries have failed, either due to broken negotiations or antitrust issues. Additionally, Intel's own manufacturing division has been losing money, making it difficult to rely on chip foundry services for new revenue growth. Then came to the rise of ChatGPT, which in the past 2 to 3 years shifted market demand sharply towards AI, catapulting NVIDIA and benefiting AMD, while further squeezing Intel's processor market share. As mentioned earlier, Intel wasn't unaware of AI's importance. The company had ventured into the GPU business early on. In 2005, Intel launched the Larrabee GPU project, but it still couldn't let go of its past. The core of the project was to develop a hybrid CPU and GPU chip, meaning Intel saw GPUs as merely supplementary to CPUs. In contrast, NVIDIA focused solely on developing high-end standalone GPUs. In 2017 to 2018, Intel also had discussions with OpenAI, now an AI darling. The two sides explored various possibilities, including Intel purchasing 15% of OpenAI for $1 billion, with an option to buy an additional 15% if Intel provided chips at cost. However, Intel's leadership didn't believe generative AI would hit the market anytime soon and didn't want to sell chips at cost. So they walked away from what now seems like a fantastic deal. Sound familiar? It's just like when they missed out on the mobile phone market. Losing the mobile boom and falling behind in the AI wave, while competitors surged ahead, pretty much sums up Intel's current predicament. It's not just Qualcomm, there were also rumors that ARM has been in touch with Intel's leadership. But initial assessments suggested that, like Qualcomm and ARM, primarily a chip design company is more interested in Intel's PC and server chip business rather than its manufacturing sector. Meanwhile, given Intel's size, any acquisition would likely face antitrust scrutiny. So the outcome of these acquisitions talks remains uncertain. Recently, Intel unveiled its latest Xeon 6 performance processor, P-Core series, designed specifically for AI solutions. This new CPU has taken performance and memory to a new level, aimed at accelerating AI inference and improving overall performance in heterogeneous systems. Many analysts believe this new generation of chips is critical to Intel's future, but whether the market will embrace it remains to be seen. Okay, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time.